Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
We'll take a look at the time lapse today from Lawrence. We started the day with some clouds, some rain, but as the day went on, sunshine dried off the streets and we had a gorgeous day. One of those days I like to say you kind of brush off the cabin fever, maybe been inside a little bit too much here lately with all the rain. Unfortunately, more rain comes back in tomorrow. So if Uncle Ted that's been with you for a few days is just getting a little bit too old, you can go out Thursday, Michael. Anyway, you've got a front down toward the south right now. It's stalled out in Columbia. Unfortunately, it did not move farther enough south. That leaves us right in the bullseye for more rain on Wednesday. You can see as we zoom in closer on live Super Doppler 4 HD, all is clear right now, and most of the evening should be clear as well. But into the overnight hours, into tomorrow, more rain will move back in. Temperatures are mild out there. We're seeing near record warmth in the south, 72 in Abbeville. Elberton, you were at 79 today. You've fallen to 74 since the sun has gone down at 61 degrees in Asheville. Now, as we head into the overnight hours, expect it to be a little bit cooler than we've had here lately. Just not too bad. Upstate in the middle 60s, lower 60s for the northern part. In the mountains, right around 57 degrees. Showers further south, cloudy skies for the mountains. For tomorrow, more clouds, more rain, and it'll be heavy at times. Starting off at 59 in Greenville, warming up to the middle 60s. In Spartanburg, scattered showers, some of which will be heavy from time to time. Look for the middle 60s. In Anderson, starting off at 59, 67 degrees by 2 o'clock. And in Asheville, look for a 54-degree start, 64 to end the day, with even a clap or two of thunder being possible with as warm as it's going to be. Now, high temperatures tomorrow will be different to wherever you live. Upper 60s to around 70 the further south, but in the Greenville-Spartanburg area, middle 60s, and for Asheville, Hendersonville, right around 60 degrees. Nationally, a lot more calm than we had yesterday with that robust, strong, severe system. Since then, we've calmed things back down, but this front, pesky as it is hanging around down toward the southeast and will provide more rain for us later on. Eventually, this cold air is going to move our way. It's been stuck out west. It moves our way by this weekend, and all indications are that cold pattern will last through January as all of our models are showing a pattern flip heading our way. Here's the very latest Future Plus model showing clouds will be on the increase overnight. Look how that front gets juiced up with some moisture later on tonight. We'll see heavy rainfall moving into our area. Right now, the timing for the heaviest rain looks to be in the afternoon, and we'll continue to see periods of rainfall tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening, before Thursday we start to clear things back out. Now, that front still does not want to go anywhere, so Thursday into Friday, it'll be far enough south that we'll stay dry, but close enough that we'll still see some clouds, especially on Friday. While everything is trying to push out to sea, we'll see mostly cloudy to cloudy skies. All clear, though, by the weekend. As far as how much rain is on the way, latest model showing 1.5 inches for Lawrence, 1 inch for Greenville, less the further you head up into the mountains, where a quarter of an inch to a half an inch will be possible. Clemson-Oklahoma game. If you're heading down to Miami, look at this. It'll be hot. Temperatures right around 80 degrees with a pretty gusty wind out there, southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. 4 day plus looks like this. We're going to see a 100% chance of rain tomorrow, the 63 degree high on Friday. Now, Saturday, 49 degrees. I did the digging. You have to go back to March to find a cooler temperature. Then, of course, on Sunday, the Bucks heading into town to Charlotte. Looking good for that forecast as well, although it does stay cool as we head into early next week, as we'll see highs in the 40s and 50s, the 30s for the North Carolina mountains, and it looks like we will stay chilly heading throughout the foreseeable future here.
Trying to get Uncle Ted out of the house, are you?
Yeah. It happens. Everybody has an
Everybody
Uncle
has
Ted,
one.
Right?
All right, Chris, thanks.